nerds, hi yogis, Carlene Rose here, and welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel. Today we are going to do a little more of a gentle morning flow, so nothing too crazy. This is great for you've just got out of bed, you're getting ready to start your day, and just wake your body up a little bit. So come to a comfortable seat. You can see I'm on my knees here, you can come to whatever comfortable seat is easiest for you. We'll start with just some shoulder rolls, forward, or I guess backward and forward, little directions. So we're just starting to wake up the body here, warming up and waking up our big muscles. Awesome, you feel like you've kind of worked out some of the sleep and the, you know, the static attention that we get when we're sleeping, is working some of that out. We'll start by activating and warming up our breath. Breath is really gonna help us focus throughout the day, give us that energy. So we'll start here in our easy seat and inhale. Warm and wide in everything, and exhale, squeeze in and out all the way from the bottom all the way to the top. Inhale here. Exhale. Getting that big Ujjayi sound. It's our victorious breath, so it's a great way to start our day, getting our victorious breath moving. And as we're inhaling, really letting everything expand, you know, in our pelvic floor, pelvic bowl area, and as we exhale, squeezing everything in and out, this is starting to activate our deep core line, so all of our core muscles. Exhale. We'll start incorporating that breath into movement, so inhale, tiny arch in the spine, exhale, curl it back, inhale here. Exhale. I can get the arms involved. Inhale, opening wide, being ready for the day. Exhale. Give yourself a hug here. Inhale, open wide. Exhale. You can switch arms that are on top. This is called breath of power or breath of freedom. A great way to start the day. Last one here. Exhale. Awesome. We'll come onto our hands and knees for a moment, get a little deeper into the spine. So inhale, exhale, big arch. Inhale here. Exhale. Good, one more time. Inhale. And exhale. Now our spine, of course, moves in more than these two directions, right? So let's move it side to side. Really starting to warm it up, wake it up, moving it in all directions. You can even do some circles with the shoulders, circle the other way. And notice for all of these, I'm really bending my elbows. I'm not trying to do this with straight arms. You don't have a lot of movement, you don't have a lot of power. So really get the arms involved. And you can go the other direction. And you can move your hips around. It's the little dance of the spine. Just feel where you have any areas in your back where they might still be a little sleepy. Might still have a little tension. Move forward and back. Take kind of a yogi's choice moment here, finding areas in your shoulders, in your back, in your spine that need breath, need some attention, need to wake up a little for your day. Now, obviously, we have so much attention to our spine because, you know, our spine and our core, those are our stabilizer muscles. Those are the root of all that we do, all of our movement. Our spine houses our nervous system, which sends messages from our brain to the rest of our body. So definitely good to get that awake, energized, ready for the day. When you've had your yogi's choice spine dance for a while, tuck your toes. We're going to inhale here and exhale as you arch, lift your knees off the ground. Inhale. Exhale. Good. Starting to get our core involved. Get our arms waking up. And this time we're going to hover and hold it. And press yourself back into a downward facing dog. Pedal out the feet. Starting to warm up the calf muscles. From here, just take a slow walk of your feet to your hands. You can even plant your feet and walk your hands back if that's easier for you. We're going to start with bent knees here in our forward fold. And from here, just clasp your two fists into the elbows. Gently rock back and forth. It's a great way to trigger the big muscles of the low back to just relax and release. It will help open up and start to wake up your hamstrings and your legs. Awesome. Now from here, we're gonna sit back down kind of. So we're gonna come onto our toes and just sit on our heels. We want to start warming up our feet. We don't really pay a lot of attention to our feet, but we're on our feet all the time. So we definitely wanna wake those up as well. And of course our feet are, you know, the foundation for the rest of our body, and their weight is on the ground when we're walking and doing all the stuff we have to do. So just rock back and forth, starting to wake up the arches. Might even feel it in your calf muscles a little. Awesome. And last one, just letting the heels reach towards the ground. You can gently rock back and forth here too. Starting to stretch out the calf muscles. And then as you plant your heels back onto the earth, keeping bent knees, wave the spine long, and then find your edge of stretch for your forward fold again. Now you'll probably notice that we're not stretching very deep, very far here. You know, if you've just woken up, you don't want to stretch too fast, too soon. So we're really just finding that first edge of stretch to wake up the body. And here you can walk out the knees, bending one knee while straightening the other leg, or making it straighter. Doesn't have to be totally straight. From here, bending the knees again and walking your hands back out into your down dog. Pedaling out the feet again, and just notice that difference that you've already made in your legs just from that tiny little bit of movement. And I'll take that through the whole body, so bending everything, bend your knees, bend your arms, get really good momentum, use physics to your advantage here, and wave yourself forward, coming into a plank. Now from here, put your knees on the ground. We're going to protect our shoulders as we do this, lowering through chaturanga, coming onto the earth. I'm just coming to rest for a moment. So we're going to inhale here, exhale, roll yourself in and out. You can come just to a baby cobra. Again, we're not super awake yet, so just getting the body moving. Exhale, inhale here, prepare. Exhale, rolling yourself in and up. Just doing some waves. Inhale here, prepare. Excellent. Now this time we're going to inhale here, coming up and keeping these on the ground, make your way back to downward facing dog. Body loves that waving motion, and that's why I keep doing it. As I'm in dog, I'm waving my legs back and forth, waving forward and backward from dog to plank. Really great way to just wake up the spine. So wave forward, this time just tiny bend in the elbows, and exhale, wave back. Notice I even wave my spine as I come into down dog.
getting that length. And the elbows, bend yourself back. One more time, inhale, bend everything. Exhale, wave yourself to plank. Tiny bend of the elbows, and exhale as you wave yourself back to downward dog. Awesome. All right, so now we are going to wave through the full vinyasa here. So bending your knees and elbows, waving yourself forward. Come onto your knees again, still lower through chaturanga. Inhale here. Exhale as you wave yourself and come a little higher and back to down dog. And this time walking your hands back to your feet, making your way into that forward fold again. Awesome, and notice just some gentle movement. It's already got energy flowing through the body. Like I said, nothing too crazy today. So from here, we're gonna bend our right knee deeper. Left leg will come straighter for you, and left arm reaches to the sky. If you're feeling it, you can even half bind, wrap around the back. Exhale, switch sides. Left knee bends deeper, right leg is straighter as the right arm reaches up. And you can half bind if you so choose. If you do it on one side, of course, I recommend doing it on the other. Exhale back to your forward fold. Now here we're gonna bend our knees deeply and rolling ourselves in and up all the way to stand. Inhale here. Exhale, awesome. Hands to heart center at namaste. From here we are going to make our way back to the floor, coming onto a seat. We'll do a little bit of core work and then call it a day. So inhale here. We're gonna come into our Navasana. You can bring your hands out if you want, or have your hands on the earth, whatever is easiest for you. But you'll inhale, exhale to center. Inhale here, exhale. Just a few of these, getting our core warmed up. And last one, this time, challenge yourself over and bring your hands up. We'll do goddess pulses. Awesome, we'll just start with take a mini break with a stretch here. Awesome, this time, everyone plant your fingertips behind you. We'll bring our legs out, come onto our right hips, and we'll do a twisted boat pose. Inhale here, exhale. Really good to use your fingertips to support you when you're doing these one hip twists. Last one on each side. And hands back up to those goddess pulses. Awesome. Relax into the earth, just stretching forward. And making your way onto your back. You can hug your knees into your chest here. Give yourself a little bit of lemon. Circle them one way and then the other. Awesome. Come out into your Shavasana. Big full body stretch here. Kind of like you do when you're just getting out of bed. Awesome. And from here, you can even stretch out the arms, bring one arm across, getting into the shoulders a little bit more. And a really good thing to do when you're waking up, especially now that we've been on our wrists a little. Massage out your forearms and grab your wrists and kind of pull your wrist away from your forearm. Gives you some good traction and helps get your wrists warmed up for the day, especially if you're going to be on a computer a lot. You can even do that while you're on the computer.
help release any wrist tension that you might get from all that typing. And from here, just release the breath, let it flow naturally now. Taking all of that energy that you just built, all of that focus, and take that in to the rest of your day, whatever you've got going on. I do hope that you enjoyed that practice, my nerdy yogi. Hopefully you find that it does great things for you, starting yoga right in the morning, right when you get out of bed. So make sure that you subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. That way you get notifications every time I got a new video for you. And then of course, get on the League of Nerdy Yogis email list. I have some exclusive content for you there, so make sure you're on it. Namaste.